Hey everybody, it's Lindsay, and it is time for my May favorites. These are always my favorite videos to do because I get to talk about products that I have been loving all month long, and I've got some good ones. I'm actually filming this in my parents' living room. I'm just sitting here on the floor because when I film in my bathroom upstairs, I get comments that I'm looking orange, and it's just the lighting in there, and I try and work with the settings on my camera and everything, but it still makes me look kind of orange. So I can assure you I'm not orange. And since a self-tanner is one of my favorites this month, I didn't want you to not like the self-tanner because I look orange or anything, because I don't look orange. So I will get started. Oh, one other thing. This will probably be my last video for a little while. I am getting married in 17 days, which seems completely nuts to me. That is so soon. I still have so much stuff to do. The wedding is actually here at my parents' house. I mean, the wedding is not, but the reception is. My parents have a couple acres here, so we're, you know, bringing in a big tent and bringing in everything that we need, and the reception is actually gonna be here. So as you can imagine, that just adds so much extra work. So I've been doing a lot of outside work, a lot going on. So this will probably be my last one for a while because then we're going on our honeymoon to Jamaica. So I probably won't see him again until July, which makes me so sad because I really do love doing this. And I feel bad that I haven't had the time to do it like I'd like to. But I will be back in no time and be doing videos regularly like I normally do. So after all that, I will finally get to my favorites. So the first thing is something that has been out for a little while. Lots of people have done videos on this, and this is John Frieda Sheer Blonde Go Blonder Controlled Lightening Spray. I'm sorry if it's getting a little bit washed out here if you can't see it that well, but it's about $8, I wanna say. When I got it, it had a $1 coupon on it, and there was a coupon in the box that it comes in as well, so I'll be using that for the next time. This is actually my second bottle. I am loving this. So if you watch my videos, you know that I was a brunette. I'm not naturally that dark of a brunette. I actually haven't seen my natural hair color since I've been about 12 years old, but my natural hair color isn't quite that dark. I do have some blonde in the front, but it is pretty dark underneath. So I got my hair highlighted 3 months ago, March 5th. So that's just about 3 months ago, and I have been using this to blend the roots, and also with just one like full head of highlights on top of that dark hair, it wasn't quite enough to like blend it out. I don't like it too streaky or too, you know, dark hair highlight. I don't like it like that as much. I like it to look a little bit more all over blonde, a little more natural. So I use this to just kind of blend it all out, and I am so happy with the way it looks. Now, I haven't used this in about 2 weeks, and I'm getting my hair done tomorrow to get it cut and a final color before the wedding and everything. But for how dark my hair was and how light it is now and how I have like no roots around my crown, that is amazing for 3 months. Those of you who highlight your hair, you know that that is amazing. So this is gonna be a way to save so much money. If you normally have to go every 6-8 weeks, you can definitely stretch it out longer with this. And I am cheap, so I'm not trying to go get my hair highlighted every 6 weeks. I would be completely broke. So this is such a great way to make your highlights last longer or lighten your hair if you have already kind of blonde hair. Says not to use it on brown hair. I don't know if it said medium brown. I think it said don't use it on dark brown or definitely not black hair. It might have said medium brown too. So if you don't have highlights or if you don't have blonde hair, don't use this, because you would have to use it all over your head. Because if you just spray this at your roots, it's just gonna kind of turn a coppery color, which is not natural, does not look good. My mom didn't like this. She felt that it turned her hair a little brassy, which it did for me. It took a while. You have to just keep using it, so it's gonna be a little bit brassy at first, at least for me, since my hair is pretty dark. But after using it for a while, it's not brassy at all. It really looks natural, and it's a very cool blonde like I want it to be. So really, really happy with this. I might have to do a full review later because I just feel like there's so much good about this. So The next one, I'll get my skincare out of the way. I have a couple skincare items. I did put in a Sephora order a couple months ago and got two skincare things, and they were both in my May favorites because they are excellent. So if you saw my Walgreens Alpha Hydroxy Acid Cream review, you know that I am now obsessed with AHAs. Chemical exfoliants. If you don't know what that is, go look up that video. I'll probably put it right here because you have to start using them. Oh my word, nothing has made my skin better between alpha hydroxy acids and the combination with my Clarisonic. My skin has been so smooth, and I have been on like skin rehab for the wedding because I had some scarring from old blemishes, and I'm the kind of girl that always has one pimple. Like just one, and it's, I'm not complaining because, I mean, I'm not complaining because it could be a lot worse than that, but it's just frustrating because you'll get one, or I'll get one, and then it'll slowly start to fade, and just when I think, great, I'm gonna have like completely clear skin, nope, another one pops up. So there's another thing in my favorites that I think has been really working for that. I'm totally sidetracking right now, but this is DDF, Doctor's Dermatologic Formula, and this is the glycolic 10% toning complex. Glycolic acid is an alpha hydroxy acid. It chemically exfoliates your skin. 10%, I believe, is the highest amount that you can get over the counter. I'm not 100% sure on that, but this is just a toner, and I have been using this every single night for weeks and weeks, and I'm about this far down of a big bottle. So this will last you a very long time. What I do is I wash my face, and then before I put anything on, I take a cotton round and I cut them in half so that they last longer and so that I don't waste so much product on it. And I just put a little bit on that. You don't need much at all. Sweep it all over my face. And then I sweep it on the backs of my hands too, and also my elbows, just because there's already extra on the cotton pad. And so I figure I can always use more exfoliation around my knuckles and things like that and on my elbows. So that's what I do. And then I also, on top of that, right after this, put on my Walgreens AHA cream. And if you have sensitive skin, you definitely don't want to start out with that right away, like double dosage of AHA. I haven't had any problems with it on my skin. I haven't had problems with, you know, I've been doing yard work. I haven't really had problems with being in the sun. I do wear, you know, SPF 55 and things like that when I'm outside on my face because I don't need a super tan face. Yeah, I haven't been having problems with it. It makes my skin so smooth, so soft. My skin has never been better than it has been for the past couple weeks, and I think there's a bunch of things that contribute to that, but this is definitely one of them. Clarisonic, this, I'll get into that, okay. So the next thing that I ordered with that Sephora order is the Basha Luminizing Black Mask. And this is what the box looks like. And, in case you're wondering, the DDF glycolic toner was about $35, which I don't think is a bad price for how long it's gonna last and for the concentration of AHA. So this one, the Basha Luminizing Black Mask, this is expensive. This is $34, $35, which for 2.8 ounces is a lot of money. So I was kind of like, wow, this better be good. I saw NER's recommendation of this, so I wanted to try it. It is a jet black, ink black mask. And if you're friends with me on Facebook, you might have seen my picture of me wearing this. Yeah, it looks crazy. So it is a peel-off mask. You put it all over your face, nowhere near your hairline, eyebrows. Don't put it too close to your eye. You wanna really put it below your, like, this bone right here. You just have to be careful because it is so hard to peel off, and you wanna put a thick layer on. You don't wanna be able to see any skin through, because if you can see, if it's too thin, then it's so hard to peel off, and it probably won't peel off. Oh, I got some on me. Okay, but so I put on a thick layer. It takes about 30 minutes to dry because of how thick it is. And then when you peel it off, it's painful. Let me just warn you, it is painful. If you are a wimpy person, this is probably not for you, but it is amazing what it does for your skin. It is so exfoliating. I peel it off, and I have to go slowly because it does kind of hurt because it's peeling off baby hairs. And not like it's like a wax strip that peels off all your hair. I mean, I obviously still have hair on my face, but you can see just these really fine hairs that it pulls off with it. So then you know if it's pulling off baby hairs that it's that strong, then it's getting in your pores. It's really cleaning it out. It's detoxifying. This is what it says, a black mask that boosts skin clarity and radiance, removes dirt and impurities while refining the look of pores. So it is amazing. I don't use this very often. I've only used it 3 times since I've gotten it. Honestly, just because I've been too busy to use it. I'd probably use it once every week and a half, like 10 days. But afterwards, my skin is so tight and so soft. I mean, pores are shrunken. It's so soft and smooth. Really nice. I wish it wasn't so expensive because it does take a lot. It's not like one of those things where, oh, you only use a little bit, so it's worth it. It's really expensive, but I don't know anything else that does this. So definitely worth checking out if that sounds interesting to you. So then my last skincare item is something I picked up several weeks ago, and this is the L'Oreal, the new Go 360 Clean Anti-Breakout Facial Cleanser. And you saw this if you watched my skincare routine video, and I hadn't used it that long, so I didn't know about it. This is an amazing cleanser. I use it every night. Has kind of a masculine, sporty cologne smell, but I really like it. It's just a gel cleanser. What I do is I put it all over my face, just with my hands, foam it up. I use it to remove my eye makeup. Unless I'm wearing waterproof, I use it to remove my eye makeup, doesn't burn my eyes, and then I rinse it off, and then I put some on my Clarisonic, and then I do my Clarisonic for a minute. Okay, I have not had one pimple in weeks, and I can never say that. I mean, I just said I'm the girl who always has one pimple. In weeks, I have never been happier with my skin. My scars are fading because I'm not getting new pimples to cause new scars, and it's just amazing. And I can't 100% attribute that to this cleanser. Part of it is I was up at school, up in my apartment in State College, and the water there is very hard and very mineralized, so it's horrible for my hair. I'm so excited to be home now and be able to have good water that my hair can finally get healthy and grow out and things like that, because it just breaks off. It's so drying for your hair, and it's like, I feel like it doesn't really get you clean. Like, it was just horrible water. So I think that contributed to me not having the best skin, but it can't just be the water, okay? This is amazing. Doesn't dry out my skin, doesn't burn my eyes, really cleans well, cleans off all my makeup, and I haven't had a pimple. And I'm just saying, for how cheap this is, I don't know, $6-7, not even that, depending on where you get it. So worth trying. So worth trying. I'm really happy with this. So then my next one, this hasn't been, I only have one makeup item this month. My next one, okay, so you know that I love my self-tanners. I love self-tanners. And I'm always on the hunt for the new best one. And I tried this one on a whim, and I'm so glad I did, because this is the best one I've tried so far. This is the True Blue Spa Vitamin E Bronzing Self-Tanning Lotion. This is from Bath & Body Works. It is $15 for 6 ounces. So it's not the cheapest, but definitely not the most expensive. It is tinted, as you can see. I think it's probably gonna look darker than it is. I don't really like really bronzing self-tanners, the kind where you put them on and you look dirty because it's all that bronzer in it. I feel like there is no point to that. Because I just use them at night, so it's just gonna rub off on my sheets, and you couldn't wear that out anyway. I mean, if it's so dark that you really, like, it just looks weird, or if it's shimmery or whatever, it's just, you cannot even wear that. So this one has a tint, which is nice because you can see where you're putting it, but it's a very natural tint. It is not so dark that you look dirty or blotchy. You could wear this out with the tint, and it does have a little bit of a shimmer, but it's not over the top or anything, which I will add to one of my yuck products for the month. That's something coming up. This smells good. I can't even describe the smell. It's not perfumey, like, it's not florally. It just, you can tell it is scented, and I can't describe the scent. I don't know why. I just cannot put my finger on what the scent is. But it's nice. And this does not, I have this luminizing black mask all over my hands now. It does not make me orange, it does not dry out my skin, and it does not smell at all. The next day after I wash it off and I'm out, you know, running around, doing whatever, if I smell my skin, it does not at all smell like self-tanner. And I'm not wearing it right now, I haven't done a self-tanner in a little while, but this is the best one I've tried so far. I did it on my face, and I can't say it didn't change my skin at all as far as dryness or anything, but did not dry it out nearly as much as so many of the others that I've tried. So really like this. The color is so natural. You know, two nights of this in a row, and the color is beautiful, lasts a long time. And I just really, really am happy with this. For the price, it doesn't smell, looks nice, lasts a long time, great. You have to try that one. So my last favorite for this month is my only makeup item. And these are nothing new, but I have been using them in combination and loving it. So you already know that I love my Neutrogena Healthy Skin. Love it, love it, love it. The most natural that a full coverage foundation has looked for me. It doesn't look cakey or dry. It gives a very natural finish. If you're really oily, this may not work for you, but if you mix it, it may work for you. So Revlon Color Stay. Everybody raves about this. People love this. It lasts forever. I mean, literally had to use eye makeup remover to get it off my hand sometimes because I mix them on my hand. Because it's practically waterproof. It lasts so long. So I have both. This one is the combination of oily skin. My color is 310 Warm Golden. I also have the one for normal to dry skin, but, okay, I'll explain why I've been combining these. Love my Neutrogena Healthy Skin, but definitely doesn't have the lasting staying power that Color Stay does. And also, I don't have really oily skin, but I waitress. By the end of a shift, if you waitress, you know you can be just kind of oily and gross. And so this doesn't hold up quite as well as I'd like it to. So what I've been doing is, I am 70 Fresh Beige in this, by the way. I've been mixing about 3/4 of this and 1/4 of this on the back of my hand. And just that little bit of the Revlon Color Stay makes it last so much nicer. Because for me, I cannot use this on its own. Revlon Color Stay is so cakey looking on my skin, it feels like, makes my skin feel like tight and taut, and I just don't like the way it looks. I think it looks too made up for me. So when I mix just a little bit of that with the Neutrogena Healthy Skin, I still get the same look of the Neutrogena Healthy Skin, but it lasts longer, keeps me a little less oily, and just looks really nice. So really liking that combo. So if you have, I'm dropping things everywhere here. So if you tried the Neutrogena Healthy Skin and you thought it was too dewy, didn't last long enough, too oily. If you've tried the Revlon Color Stay and you thought it was too cakey, too heavy, too full coverage, try combining them. Because I really, really am liking this month. So, I have one more product to talk about. It is not a favorite. Could never even consider it a favorite. It is the crappiest product of the month, possibly of the year. No, it's not crappiest product of the year, but I hate, hate, hate it. And I can't even give it that fair of a review because I didn't even let it sink in. So this is the L'Oreal Sublime Bronze Luminous Bronzer Self-Tanning Lotion Instant Action. And it says, beautifully radiant sun-kissed look, smoothing action, and golden illumination. Okay, so I picked this up on my bachelorette weekend because looking at it, here, I'll squeeze a little bit out. It looked like really nice, beautiful color, like it would just give me kind of like a golden sheen, and I wanted a little bit of self-tanner. I wanted a little bit of self-tanner because we were on the beach, but we really didn't get that much color. So I put this on after my shower, after the beach, because we were getting ready to go out. We were going out to Secrets. Oh my word, this is not at all a golden sheen. This is disco ball glitter. No lie, I have never seen anything this sparkly. This is practically sparklier than body glitter. It was disgusting. When I stood in front of the sun, I literally looked like a disco ball, and I could not go out like that, so I had to wash it off. So I can't even tell you what this color develops to, but to me, something that is so unnecessary to put glitter in a self-tanner. If you wore this out, it would look ridiculous. You would look like you are 12 again, in the late 90s, where body glitter was all the rage. It was just so over the top, so glittery. I don't mind a shimmer, I don't mind a sparkle even, but full on glitter, like silver glitter in the sun, it was just, ugh, looked horrible. I would have looked ridiculous going out in this, so I washed it off. So that's a big disappointment. I'm gonna be returning this. I wanted to wait until I showed you this. It says new fresh scent, great. Great if it smells great, it looks like crap. And you can't wear this. So even if you do it before bed, who wants to put body glitter on before bed and then get that all in your sheets? And then even when you're not wearing this, you're gonna wake up with glitter because you had glitter in your sheets now. Like, that is so stupid to me. Why put glitter in this? What are you thinking, L'Oreal? What are you thinking? So that is crappiest product of the month. Not happy about it at all. Really made me mad. So that is it. This has probably been the longest favorites video ever. But I will see you probably in July unless I can find a little bit of time to film another video. So I will definitely be missing you, and I've appreciated all your warm wishes, and I will talk to you later. So see you, everybody.